What's up? This is Dr. Lassa Mohammed. Welcome to Online Clinic. If you are new here, try to subscribe. After subscribing, click on the bell so you get updated on drop our next video. Now, welcome to the clinic. 2 weeks back, I dropped a video on coronavirus, and ever since, things have been getting interesting. I've been having more updates. I want to keep you guys updated on the coronavirus. Now, the coronavirus is also known as the SARS-CoV-2. That's SARS-CoV-2. Now, this virus is was originated in a city in China called Wuhan. Wuhan is a kind of a medium city in China, and report getting to us said that this virus was discovered in a market in China. This market is known for selling exotic animals. Now, these animals are could be dead animals in which they prepare or they cook it for their customers to feed on the animals. Now, report got into us said that the virus was gotten from there, and ever since then it has spread all over China and other parts of the world. Now let me shed more, let me keep you guys more updated on new development and how you can help yourself and some likely things that can help you. Now report has shown that this virus itself is like a genetic mutation. What mean mutation? Mutation means when something is original but it's being changed by, it can be the environment, sun, anything can change something to any other thing that is more related to it. Now this coronavirus has been said that it is not a human virus, it is a mutated virus from snakes, then from snakes so it's mutated in bat that can also affect humans. Now the report said that the coronavirus is in bat that affect humans. I don't know who hit bat, but I know some people feed on bat, but I don't think that is so good. Now this infection doesn't cause running nose, you understand, because we all know that one of the symptoms of the infection is like you have flu, influenza and stuff like that, but this infection doesn't cause running nose, because when you have someone sneezing and having running nose, you start getting scared that person is already infected with coronavirus. Now this virus doesn't cause running nose. It causes dry hardened cough or dry nose. If the patient just starts sneezing without having mucus or discharge from the catheter or the cough you get. Now also this virus cannot survive more than 27 degrees Celsius. Now 27 degrees centigrade. Now in which if you have in a region when the temperature is kind of high, there's a high tendency in which the virus cannot survive more in that region, in which the number of affected person or infected person might be reduced. And also if you try to keep yourself warm, in which taking things that are hot, it can also help you in keeping yourself safe, because the virus cannot survive more than 27 degrees Celsius. And again, it is very advisable for you to drink what? Drink a lot of water. What you should also want to keep yourself hydrated, because the virus can also make you dehydrated. And also taking water can also help you flush your throat, because the virus is said to settle in the throat before going into your lungs, then from your lungs before you get symptoms of pneumonia and stuff like that. But we'll get you into that shortly. Now now the virus, we said it's transmitted, and once if an infected person, it's a very true droplet, and once you have a droplet on surfaces, now to tell you how long it can stay on surfaces. And now for metal surfaces like your windows, your metal handle doors and stuff like that, it can survive 12 hours on your metal surfaces. The virus can be there living on that surface for the next 12 hours, in which once you have contact with such affected surface and it comes to your hand and you touch your face or your nose or any opening part of that leads into your body, the person gets infected. Now for your metal surface, the virus survived for 12 hours. While your fabrics, your cloth, the virus can survive just 6 to 12 hours also, but it's less than 12 hours, just 6 to 10 hours the virus can survive on fabrics and cloth. While in your hands, your palm, if you have contact with the virus that's in your palm, it can only survive 10 minutes on your hand. After 10 minutes, the virus dies on your hand. So it is advisable always wash your hands frequently, because you're always touching surfaces and getting in contact with stuff. So you have to always wash your hands regularly. Now, how does this virus work? Now, this virus settles, once it gets into your body, it settles in your throat for 3 to 5 days. Now, once it is in your throat, it starts giving you this sensation of coughing and sneezing in your throat. Then on the fourth day, it travels from your throat and go into your lungs, from the pipe of your throat to your lungs. It settles in your lung. Then from your lung, it causes this pneumonia symptom of you having pneumonia and you're getting feverish. The one person is getting feverish, then there's high fever, there's high body temperature, then the person have difficulty in breathing, then from there can cause death of the person. Now, one of the solutions, I'll be giving solutions of how you can help yourself. Now, first, you should always try to goggle your mouth with sanitizing solution. Once you try to goggle your mouth, you goggle your throat also, in which if you have a settled virus on your throat, you can always goggle and bring it out, in which the virus dies. It doesn't have a chance to get into your lungs or causing such symptoms also. And again, I talked about drinking a lot of water. Now, if you drink a lot of water, it can also help you flush the virus from your throat into your stomach, in which the acid in your stomach, because your stomach, you have what they call hydrochloric acid. This acid can actually kill the virus once it gets in your stomach. So taking a lot of water also can also help you in preventing yourself, and also washing your hands regularly. No matter what you're doing, once your hand get in contact with surfaces, you should always wash your hands regularly. Now, the use of nose masks. I would say nose masks is used for only affected patients. People that are already affected with the virus should use nose mask, but we should always get ourselves prevented or always get ourselves ready. You can also use nose mask, but basically nose mask that is good for you, that is advisable for you, to what the N95 nose mask, which is purifies or sieves 95% of the atmospheric content you get. So, and also, what is the idea of using nose mask when you don't wash your hands regularly? Because your hands get in contact with your phone, your wallet, your wristwatch, and stuff like that. So you should also wash your hand regularly. And also, we want to talk about what you can do also. We know for flu and influenza, if you have such disease or such infection, you should always take warm water. But this time, you add what lemon, slice of lemon in hot water can also help you. So what you do is that you get hot water, you slice your lemon in it, then cover it. Then after 30 minutes, you take it. It can also help you concern the symptoms and also the virus. Then also, water with ginger. Also gingered water. That is putting water in your ginger in hot water, then covering and taking it, also can also help you also. Now, if you say you want to go to the hospital to get yourself checked when you have symptoms already, that means your body that already got into your body 50% already. That means it's like destroying your body, gotten and finished the in your throat and have got into your lungs already. So that means already got into your body. So today I'll be teaching you what you can do in which to know if you are good or not. Now, it is every morning what you have to do is this: you come out and you take a fresh breath. Now, once you take a fresh breath, you have to hold your breath for 10 seconds. Now, if you do that successfully without having this coughing or without having this difficulty, you understand, that means you are okay. Now, once you do that and you have the difficulty in breathing, or you cannot breathe properly, or you are coughing after the 10 seconds, the damage, you have to get yourself checked before any other symptom. I think if you do this, you can get yourself detected before you start experiencing the symptom, and that will help you overcome this virus. I hope this video has been okay for you guys. I hope this video will be able to teach you guys. Kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel and see you next time. Bye bye.